thank you for joining us for another virtual field trip at Pythagora. Come along with us in one of three installments on an important Moravian figure, Count Nicholas von Zinzendorf.
Born in Dresden, Germany on May 26, 1700, Nicholas Louis, Count and Lord of Zinzendorf and Pottendorf, was welcomed by his two loving parents. This happiness was short-lived due to the premature passing of his father only 6 weeks after Nicholas's birth. His mother, Charlotte Justina, Baroness of Gerstorf, remarried 4 years later to a field marshal from the Prussian army. Shortly after the nuptials, Nicholas was placed in the care of his grandmother until his 10th year. No mention is given regarding the difficulty for seeing his mother, but her new husband's military service could have been an underlying factor. Zinzendorf received his formal education in both Halle and at the University of Wittenberg. Halle's reputation was one of great piety, which means a highly religious school and area, and this period marks Zinzendorf's love for God becoming more intimate and profound. In the years raised with his pious grandmother, she taught him the Word of God and greatly influenced his life devotion to the Lord. After finishing his formal education, Zinzendorf began his travels through Western Europe. After a few years of travel, the young count finally returned back to Dresden. With him was a greater knowledge of the Lord, and also a few unexpected friendships. While visiting Paris, he made friends with a Catholic archbishop named Cardinal Louis Antoine de Noailles. Interesting thing is that Zinzendorf was Lutheran, and due to the relationship at the time of Protestant religions and Catholic religions, it was just a very interesting friendship. Now, after his return, it was time to pursue a career, much to the urgence of his mother and grandmother. The two thought since his father was one of the premier ministers at the court of Saxony, it was only fit he should fill in his father's shoes. 'Twas short-lived, though, as he saw a greater work was needed for the corruption of the Lutheran Church and also helping those in need. In Zinzendorf's words, "It is my intention to help those poor souls that are oppressed and persecuted, creating unanimity and bestowing upon them the love for and from God."
By May 1722, the young adult began the process of purchasing land for an estate, which was an area named Berthelsdorf. Following the acquisition of land, Zinzendorf had his sights set on marriage. His suitor would be Countess Erdmuth Dorothea. The two married shortly after in front of a large assembly on September 7, 1722. The Count felt it appropriate to disclose his life devotion to divine work and his shunning of all vanity and vice to his new wife. Mind you, as he was seeking the hand of the Countess, his purpose in his work for God would be fulfilled after he received intelligence of a group of exiles arriving in Lusatia, the region where the Count had purchased a tract of land named Berthelsdorf. At an earlier date not specified, Zinzendorf met a man by the name of Christian David while visiting the small village of Schweinewitz. David spoke of the dire situation in Moravia for the brethren, and Zinzendorf was more than willing to open his doors for those oppressed. The exiles could live according to their own consciousness, so they arrived shortly after on June 17, 1722. A petition from the exiles to Zinzendorf stated their gratitude. "We must humbly entreat you to take us into your gracious protection, to assist us, poor, afflicted, and simple people, and to treat us with kindness and affection." Now we begin to understand how Zinzendorf began his journey with the Moravians in saving these repressed and persecuted people. Please join me next time when we discuss the establishment of the Moravian Church and the appointment of Zinzendorf as bishop and theologian for a once persecuted religion. Thank you.